one of India's best institute, IIT Madras. After two massive reforms of GST and demonetization, there is a lot of expectation riding on the finance minister as he prepares to present the full budget before the elections in 2019. Joining me are students from the Department of Management Studies. What are your expectations from this budget as young job seekers? What are your expectations? There is a lot of talk about the setting up of national employment policy. So what do you have to say about this as a young job seeker?
I believe that the Niti Aayog has recently highlighted the severe unemployment and underemployment that India is facing currently. Therefore, the national employment policy that you talk of will have to include within its various levels of economic, social, as well as labor interventions. As a young job seeker, I believe that skill development will be one of the key factors that any youngster would be looking for. Therefore, the finance minister, I believe, will have to emphasize on better spending on skill development, better training institutes, especially in non-urban areas, better training of the teachers.
We'll come to skill development in a bit. Talking about job creation itself, there is a lot of gap when it comes to job creation. We do not have jobs for the youth of this country. The unemployment rate is very high. As someone who's going to look out for a job next year, what are your concerns and what do you want from this budget?
See, I would like to give a different perspective to this. On the ground, if you see, there are a lot of youngsters who finish a degree. They don't only look for jobs, they also look for entrepreneurial opportunities. And government has started an initiative, which is Startup India, which is picking up well, but it's still in two early stages. Lot of youngsters are now not even ready to take highly paid jobs, but instead want to take up research or startup. Subsidies, loans and tax concessions should be introduced in the budget. This is one of the requests from my side, which will really motivate people who wants to take up research and also startups, do startups as well.
Okay, talking about a startup itself, we do see the startup culture that is growing in India. And do you think in a way that the government should give a tax concession to these people to foster innovation? Because we do have many schemes from the government as well.
As far as the startup goes, it's not just the people who are starting, but rather the concession should be on the investment too. People who are coming for the investment, they should be more, it should be more welcoming for them. So there should be definitely cuts in that and more motivation, so that startup is just an integrated approach, which includes investment, economy, and the selling part of it. So definitely there should be more welcoming features from this budget.
One thing that you want from the union minister?
As we all know, Indian economy is completely backing up by the banking industry, and strengthening of banking industry might help the economy to grow, and it will create more and more opportunities for the banks to provide loans, as they told MSME, and those groups has to be addressed, because strengthening of banks will help us to provide loans towards the mudra, and those kind of things will give more employment opportunities to the people. As you have seen that the employment opportunities through the mudra loans and MSME enterprises has grown, for 5.5 crores of employment opportunities has been created last 5 years after. So it will be helpful if we strengthen the banks, and the union budget has budgetary allocations towards the banks for capital infusion of 2.11 crores and 11 lakh crores, and it will be more helpful for the banks to give a sustainable economy to India.
So you're talking about banking reforms. If I can come to you, your expectation from this budget?
What I actually want is the government should nurture the startup culture and also focus on not only job creation but also entrepreneurs who can actually create job and contribute to the economy. So not only depend on the government but also the citizens should come up.
So you're talking about how they should be focused on the startup culture as well. Let us get a voice from here. Your expectation from this budget?
So majorly two things government should give concentration towards. One is skill distribution and skills diversity. Okay. Because as an active job seeker, I see a clear gap of skill diversity, because typically government is or any education institution for that matters are typically concentrating into, you know, the primary skills, like if it is engineering or if it is medical, they are just concentrating only on the primary skills, but they are not giving strong emphasis to the all the supplementary skills that is required for an employability program. So the not only developing the primary skills is important, giving equal importance for all the other ancillary skills is also very important. So the government should also look into that perspective as well when it comes to skill development.
Well, thank you so much all of you for joining us on this very special episode. So the brightest minds from here in IIT Madras talk about a youth-centric budget, a budget that concentrates on creation of job and the thrust of skill development and the ease of doing business.